Okay, we are here. Let's get right to it. Let's not dilly-dally. As said in the description, I will not be fussed about viewership numbers today. I've still got to do that poll on ideal times for streams, so hopefully that'll make things better either way. Yes, Logos Logistics, glad to see you. Baruch Hashem. Baruch Hashem. Blessed is the Lord. Why even say Hashem? That's a Jewish novelty. That's like, oh, we can't say the name of Yahweh because we're too unworthy, blah, 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 despite the fact that he condescends to us and all that jazz. Yeah, nah. Baruch Yahweh. Baruch Yahweh. That's my go. That's my jazz. And that's how we're going to treat it here. We're the people of Israel here, don't forget. This is space Israel, not space rabbinic Judaism, and not space modern state of Israel, where we are more than happy to proclaim and declare the name of the Lord, not literally the words, the name, but the name of the Lord, Yahweh. We pronounce Yahweh. We pronounce him, blessed be Yahweh. And as said before the abrupt end of the last stream, we are making the preparations for war with these hostiles to our right. I wonder if the cheat remained in. Nah, it didn't, so I've got to turn on free policies again because I don't have the xenophobe ethic, which doesn't allow me to have an extermination policy and only displacement. But for this roleplay, it is the grace of God. That's the console and allows us to exterminate the other species in the promised stars. Andrew Bailey, good to see ya. And he says, let's do it. Ooh, we've got five people watching now. Not bad. People, please interact in the chat. We definitely want to get that happening, which reminds me, I'm going to pull up my phone so I can actually see the chat while we're playing. But yes, we are making the warpath. We've got two decent fleets here. I'm probably about to found a third fleet. Because of this game, something I learned is that you don't want to just make a Doomstack fleet, because wars in the game often go along multiple lanes. This might not be the case here. It looks like it's pretty linear, although even then, you know, it can change up. But you always want to have multiple fleets so you can do multiple things at a time, like guard a single spot, for example, while another fleet goes and causes chaos. Ooh, Copper, good to see you. Shalom. Live long and prosper, you say? Excellent. Louis Petolicho? Petolicho? Is that how you pronounce it? Shalom. And Logos, salam, salam, salam alaikum. I hope she, Alex, comes in so you can give the Arabic diversity. But shalom, shalom to all you gents. Shalom aleichem, which is the equivalent to the Arabic assalamu alaikum. So, yes, that is us, boys, ladies and gentlemen. Oof, so many people. I'm glad to see it. Let's get interacting in the chat. Give us your days, people. How are you guys going? Ooh, oh, yes, we need to extend our deal. Oop, I need to get more. Yes, I need to get more energy to be able to extend our research agreement. Yes, we would like to extend our deal. Please give us your days. Louis, it's pronounced Smith. Most of the letters are silent. Right here. Right, right. I got ya. Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, this is getting serious. Okay, so. Oh. Oh, no. The guy to our south. Oh, dear. He just laid claim to the Vartivar system, which is right here. Okay, done it. This is not ideal. So. Okay, they're both hostile, which means it is very possible that they could both declare on me, maybe even simultaneously. Who's more powerful? I don't know yet. They're both relatively large. And I need to keep expanding too. I need to not stall like that. I need to keep expanding my territory, keep building mining stations, maximize my economy. That's what you got to do with this game. You got to keep building. You can't waste time. This is going to be very interesting. You go there. You build a new outpost there. You're doing that. What should I do? Okay, so I'm pretty much going to have to split my military in two. Yeah, because both these guys, what I'm thinking I might do is focus on a purely defensive posture with one while I go and maybe preemptively attack. I probably won't even preemptively attack. I'll wait for one of them to attack me first. And then so that I can have the most time as possible to prepare. Logos. The David Yafe Enaim Huroe Beshoshanim. My Hebrew sucks, and those aren't Hebrew letters anyway, so I can barely even tell. Andrew says, been busy studying networking vulnerabilities all day for my college courses. Fun stuff. That's fun. Heck yeah, you can help out the Russian hackers with the war. Nah. Kopo or Chopo says Alex should do a space Shiite playthrough. That'd be fun. Why not? Hey, maybe we even verse each other. We do a multiplayer game. He's the Ayatollah, and I am the King of Israel. Logos Logistics, space jihad. Heck yeah. Lewis Petrushula, what's the Jewish version of jihad? I'm not aware of the Hebrew equivalent for jihad, because jihad refers to struggle, and that can be war, offensive warfare against the unbeliever, but also personal struggle, spiritual struggle, all that. The closest I can kind of think of would be cherem, which is the Hebrew term that refers to the ban. So, like, you're putting something under the ban. That can be multiple things. Something can be declared cherem, like certain acts, for example, certain behaviors, as in the Torah. But also, even things that you sacrifice to Yahweh are considered cherem. So, fundamentally, it refers to something devoted to Yahweh for destruction. It can refer to behaviors that are literally banned, but primarily it refers to things that are devoted to Yahweh, sacrificed to Yahweh for destruction. But also refers to the extermination of cities in the Promised Land, in Israel's Promised Land, because they're going to move in there and they're not going to intermingle with the locals and adopt their ways. And so they're considered, the city is considered cherem. So the people and all the stuff in it, sacrifice to Yahweh, it's cherem. That's how it works. Logos Logistics raises index finger into the air while Arabic chanting can mix this. Someone let's blast that in a sheet and then get on a watch list somewhere. Okay, I need to look at... How's my defense platforms looking? Okay, they look... Yeah, they suck. Anyway, upgrade that. Reactor booster. We're all sweet. I need a Hebrew name. What should I name this design for the defense platform? My Hebrew vocab sucks. Let's get the Hebrew word for fortress. What's the Hebrew word? Strong's Hebrew fortress. Like a mighty fortress in our God. Matsud. No, that's net. What did they say fortress? That's not a fortress. There's Chael. Oh, yeah. Yeah, there is. Or Mibsar? Okay, this makes... Mivsar. Okay, we're going to call it that. There we go. Mivsar class. Class defense platform. There we go. And auto upgrade, because that makes things... Actually, do I... No, I don't do auto upgrade. Or do I? Actually, I think I do. Yeah, no, I do. I should do that. Yeah, because it makes things easier, so I don't have to manually upgrade everything. So I'll do that. and I need to start building my next... Ooh, yes, let's build you some shipyards. Get you a disruption field. Chopo, does this harem have the same root as the Muslim haram? Yes, it does. I believe it is the same root. Logos Logistics, Iron Dome, Migdol. I second the Iron Dome, lol. I think the Iron Dome because there's only one type of defense platform you can really get in the game. Actually, the Iron Dome would be more suited to like a more defensive platform that has like anti-air and all that stuff. So I'll probably call it that. I'll probably do that. I'll make a second defense platform, because I normally do that. A second defense platform that's focused on point defense and missile interception, which is what the Iron Dome is, and that's what I'll do. Although that is a carryover from the modern state of Israel, which we are not, but that works too. Let's get you surveying more systems. Actually, you know what? Even better. What do you got? What are your bonuses? Ooh, both of you are pretty rad. You know what? You are gonna excavate this site. Congratulations, buddy. You're going to build a station here. We have a lot of archaeological sites here, which is very good, because archaeological sites can give you some absolutely ridiculous bonuses in this game when you complete them. Benjamin, good to see you, buddy. Chopo, according to the Wikishinary entry for Haram, it does. Yep. Okay, I am... Louis says, okay, I am convicted. I need to confess. It's not pronounced Smith. You bloody liar. You know what the punishment for liar is in the Bible? I'm actually not totally sure. If you bear false witness, if you charge someone with a, if you are a witness to someone that they committed a crime, but it's found to be false, you will receive the same punishment as they do. I believe that's in Leviticus. Yeah, somewhere in Leviticus. Or Deuteronomy. Ah, good to see you all here. Yes, please, let's chat everything theology, Bible, jazz, particularly the Torah, as per this series. And when I need to, when I'm unsure about what the Torah requires me to do in a certain situation, I'm going to whip open my Net Bible, and if necessary, my Hebrew or my Septuagint Bibles up there. Okay, it's actually Petolicchio. Got ya. So that sounds Italian. Logos, the stakes of slander were pretty high in Israel. That's right. And one second, I'm just going to turn on my fan. I'm also curious, is the game volume good so far? Because if not, I can turn it up a bit. Like, did you hear that when the guy said that? Hopefully the volume's all G. Now I need to get building ships really fast. The 12 tribes of Israel. I'm naming every new fleet after a tribe of Israel. So 12 tribes of Israel. Reuben, Simeon, Levi, Judah, Dan, Gad. Blah, 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 blah. So Judah's one of the big tribes. What's like the next? I guess I'll go the tribe of Joseph. So we'll call the next one Yosef. We'll call the next fleet the fleet of Yosef. Perfecto. Logos says, so are we the divine council for this game? I guess so. You guys are the divine council. You guys are the council of El for this game. Ultimately, it's my decision and I have the highest wisdom, but you are the council. I'll hear what you guys have to say. Okay, we have one shipyard here. So let's get building some corvettes. So I'll build 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2 here. And these guys are going to be for the fleet of Yosef. So the kind of role-playing aspect here is that the main fleet, Hayad Elohim, is kind of drawing from everyone. But the individual tribal fleets, like Yehuda, for example, or Judah, they draw their fleet manpower from their tribes. So the fleet of Yehuda draws its manpower from the tribe of Yehuda. So hopefully that makes plenty of sense. And I need to upgrade these fleets while they're stationed. Because war is coming very, very soon. Probably. And yes, we need to build defensive platforms. Yes, and I need to build the Iron Dome. I'm going to build the Iron Dome defense platform. So this goes side by side with the other one. Do I really even need a missile defense? Actually, yeah, I think missiles are pretty. They're pretty decent. Sentinel point defense. Let's get two of that and two flak batteries. And also nuclear missiles. That's like the weakest missile in the game, funnily enough. And equal deflector and armor. Okay, and we're sweet for that. So let's just, I'm not even gonna give it. Oh, is there Hebrew words? If someone can, like, because I'm so lazy. Strong, you know what, let's pause. Okay, game's paused. Strong's Hebrew iron. I need it to be an adjective. So that's a noun. That's Basel. Noun. I need the adjective. Adjective. Proper name, masculine, no. No, I could just say a dome of iron. Yeah, dome of iron. That works easy. It doesn't have to be an adjective. Yes. Okay. No Vuk Stefanovic Karadzic Bible. And Logo says, let us make a fleet in the image of Habanim Yosef. That's right. Louis says, can't help you with Hebrew, fam. I can barely speak Hebrew. Nah, it's fine by me. I was being lazy for a second. So, Barzel, and then we need Strong's Hebrew dome, because I know dome is used in the Bible. Maybe not. Okay, interesting. Greek, Hebrew. I think the closest thing I can think of is the firmament, so the iron firmament. expanse, Rakia Bazel. Let's call it that. Let's confirm that's Bazel, yes. Alright, there we go, the Iron Dome, the Iron Firmament, Rakia Bazel. Dome of Iron, Firmament of Iron. Boom, there we go, okay. So that's going to be important for defense for our stations. Okay, we're out of alloys, that's okay. We got plenty of other resources to sell so we can buy more alloys. Lovely doubly. Alright. Tropo, Rakia. And Logos says, are there items in this game which are analogous to books or scrolls? If there are, can you name them after the books of the Bible? Unfortunately not. The closest thing I got was that in the first one, I think you were here, in the first one we captured the enemy pirate fleet's battleship, which happens to be quite powerful. And so that's basically the Ark of the Covenant, the Aron Yahweh, the Ark of the Lord. So that's the kind of the closest thing. There's not really any books or that in this game. There are special items you can find through archaeological things, and they give you nice bonuses. So maybe I can try get some analogous stuff here or there. Okay, let's definitely upgrade these planetary administrations. But apart from that, you can't really do that. Oh my gosh, we're suffering with amenities. People become clerks. Far out. That's what I hate with this game. Like, the AI just does not know how to prioritize new jobs. It's so retarded. Oh, here we go. New first contact. Bring greetings from the Grand Marshal Pagro, the undisputed ruler of the Cervelio Combine. Respect our borders and keep our affairs. Perhaps our minor feelings. Yeah, yeah, whatever, mate. These guys adjacent to us? Okay, they are not, which means that they do not need to be exterminated by us. They are lucky. But we will conquer them, nonetheless. And they will become our vassals. Maybe enslave them if we take their planets. Tropo says Rakia means firmament. God is a Serb. Ew, please no. That would kind of shake my Christian faith there if that was true. Louis says Balkans rise up. We was Balkans and she. Construction complete. And they close their borders to us. Of course, we shall do the same. Why does everyone just hate us? Ooh. Hey, nice. We got some minor artifacts. New research done. Ah, perfect. We got the energy stuff. Yes, planetary inhibitors, we definitely need that. Well, starbase inhibitors. And I think I'll build another okay, perfect. We got okay, we got Yehuda Hail Hayam. Okay, Yosef. We got the fleet of Yosef. Yes, that's true. Okay, Logos says, who is Space Assyria? Who is Space Babylon? So, they're not in the Promised Land. They're going to be coming much later once we find the rest of the galaxy and find out who the major powers are. But these guys right next to us, the Adiks and the Poblin, they are effectively the Canaanite Philistine confederations whom we're going to exterminate. Or the Canaanites particularly. So, yes, that's what we are going to be considering. These guys right next to us are the Canaanites, and the other powers will remain to be seen as to who they are. And now we need to get a fleet admiral. Little lifespan. Yeah, that'll do. That's interesting. So is it cost? Oh, okay. So Unity, that's interesting. Okay. So the latest update, which has come out after the first episode, the latest update has made Unity a much more central thing in this game. So now leaders don't cost energy anymore, thank God. But now they cost Unity. So that's that might be an issue for us in the future. I'm not sure, because in accordance with the Torah, we can only have one temple. And the problem with that is that with religious empires, temples are a primary means of generating Unity in this game. So I can't build multiple temples. So I have to go to other sources for Unity, which is possible. It's very doable, but it does handicap us a little bit. So it's going to be interesting to see how that turns out for us. And now I'm going to do my typical tactic where I have this fleet bordering the next system where the energy entry enters in. My defensive strategy is that I have my system with the star base that the enemy will immediately attack. It's nice and beefed up. But I have my fleet waiting at the very edge and able to immediately jump into that system as soon as the enemy attacks, because the enemy AI doesn't calculate your fleets in adjacent systems, at least the vast majority of the time it doesn't. So they can bring in a fleet that's just enough to take out your starbase, but then you can have another fleet waiting right next to them that's massive and can crush them, because with the combined weight of your fleet and your starbase. And so as soon as they're engaged, I jump in and they can't pull out. They'll get destroyed. Chopo says to Louis, no, please let that schizo Vucic stay schizo on his own. Benjamin, we was Balkans. We was Balkans. Chopo, Paul plays as space the faction. Also, Paul, why does everyone hate us? Realism in this game is uncanny. Well, yes, I did just make my intentions known to exterminate all our neighbors and then subdue the rest of the galaxy. Hey, why does everyone hate us? That's not cool, man. Come on. Oh, man. Louis says, the real schizos are the friends we made along the way. Heck yeah, I'm happy to call all my homies in this chat schizo. Let's put a S in the chat for schizo. We're all schizos together, boys. I need another... Okay, let's build a starport here, but I definitely need another... Whatchamacallit? Hang on.
Construction.
I need another anchorage so that I can, because we're currently a bit over budget with fleet upkeep, just because it's more than what we can handle at the moment. Sirius station. Okay, perfect. We'll build one. Oh, but I want the off-world training. We don't need that right now. We need the anchorage. If I can... Hang on, what? Crew quarters. Why can't I build an anchorage? What the heck? Oh, no, that's for up here. Yeah, okay, whatever, we'll get an off-world trading company. We definitely need that. We're in an energy deficit. All the chat coming together. We're all schizos together, boys. Get in your friends. Any friends, any other Christian friends you know who would love to be in this community of the Space Israel, who you think will enjoy this stream, please share it to them right now. Get them in. Get them involved in the chat. Because that's what sets me apart from other streamers. I am going to be deeply involved with my chat. We're going to be interacting a lot. Okay, what's the next one? One additional clerk job. Habitat, blah, blah, blah. Also produce additional clerk jobs. Additional housing. Let's go with interstellar franchising first. That's good. Adopting resources and stability. Okay, perfect. Cool. Okay, it's good that I adopted the prosperity unity tradition tree earlier than what I normally would have, because we need that to get all the resources we can, and thus all the resources we can, and thus as much resources to fight war as early as possible. Chopo says, bro, normal people be sleeping by right now. It's only for American Eastern Standard Time, it's only around 7:30, isn't it? Sleeping, huh? It's the late morning for me. Also, I'm bound to go to sleep soon. Boo! Nah, kidding. Get that sleep pattern in, bruh. All G. I'm just happy you came along. I'm happy there's a bunch of people who did come along for today. It's lifted my spirits since yesterday. Keep digging. Build mining station. Okay, the fleet of Yosef is nice and buffered. I'm curious, how big is their station here? That's 823. Ours is 906. Oh, yeah, we're going to smash them all. And definitely as well with this game, you want to build science stations everywhere. Oh, mad. Autotrathon... Hang on, what? Why is the Autotrathon monument there and not a temple? That's good. So, context, this thing, the Autotrathon monument, normally, in before this update at least, spiritualist empires wouldn't get this. They'd get the temple and it would effectively do the same thing. And why that was going to be a problem was because I couldn't only build one temple. But now we have this Autotrathon monument rather than temples. Okay, cool. No, we have both. Because the Autotrathon monument that produces one unity. It increases the amount of unity we get from jobs, which is good. So the priest jobs generated by the temple will generate even more unity. And also, it produces one extra unity per ascension perk, which is good. We're about to get another one. Okay, still a disadvantage, though, because temples produce, like, 16... The priests produce 16 unity from the temple, so... Still not ideal, but it's actually good, because we normally wouldn't get this as a spiritualist. Actually, no, I'm not going to build this first. I'm going to build... research labs. Yes, that's what we need. But that's good. That's actually good. Oh dear, we have a bunch of temples. Okay, that's not good. That is not good at all. We have three temples, two of them on our home world and one on Ashdod. Oh, this hurts, but we have to get rid of it. Oh, this hurts. Okay, research labs. Hang on. Oh, this hurts so much. We're going to lose so much unity. Oh, but I have to do it. Okay, I can replace it. Oh, they don't generate unity anymore. Oh, no, that's not good. Ah, oh, it should be slightly offset, I guess. But, oh, that hurts. That really, really hurts. That's what happens. This is why this is a challenge. We have to follow the Torah. Oh, boy. Ooh, Eric Bishop. G'day, g'day. Nice to meet your acquaintance. He says, Space Zionism. Chopo says, 1 a.m. here. Logos says, can confirm 7:30 p.m. EST. Best time zone, base. Oh, man. Okay. And Logos is describing the other Paul's role-playing as the Kingdom of Israel. He must act in accordance to the Torah. So he's naming his armies and cities Hebrew names, and he's waging war according to the laws in the Torah. Eric Bishop replies, Inshallah, he will conquer the galaxy. Inshallah, brother, inshallah. Glad to see you here, buddy. Glad to see you. Whoa, okay, we are losing energy, food, and consumer goods. Ooh, okay. So it's not, okay, that's not the worst deficit, but we definitely need more. So these guys are losing food. One more farmer job, build another. Because the thing with this game, right, you build districts that produce the different basic resources you need, but your pops need to grow in order to fill those jobs. So you can build a farm that builds two farmers, for example, but they're not going to be immediately taken up unless there are unemployed pops, which you don't want because they'll cost you. So these are the available jobs. Down the worker section, as you can see, there's three vacant farmer jobs, there's one vacant miner job, and six vacant technician jobs. So literally no one's gone for energy. That is so retarded. Oh, that's because I prioritized clerks because they weren't being... Yeah. Okay, that's... Okay, okay, that's actually not bad. Okay, no, it's not changed anything, actually. Hang on. Okay, that's good. It doesn't automatically change them back. That used to be the case before the... Okay, no, we got two technicians again. Okay, that should offset some stuff. But now we need a... Okay, these problems aren't bad. We can let them hang for a bit, but I think we can build some more stuff. This must be, Eric Bishop, this must be very difficult with no immigration. You'd be surprised, actually. Like, pretty much, this might be a bit of a Freudian slip, but pretty much every single one of my Stellaris games, I play an authoritarian empire that doesn't allow immigration with other species. Almost every time. But sometimes I like to play like the multi-ethnic, multinational republic, so I will. But it's actually not that difficult. I mean, like, in the early game, you don't have any immigration with any other species at all, so it's not the biggest difficulty. You have immigration between your planets, that's fine, but with your home species, but yeah. I mean, Israel wasn't against... I might have to change those laws, because Israel wasn't against all immigration, but you had to be of the covenant community. You had to be circumcised, you had to be a proper Torah observant Jew. Or Israelite, rather. Jew is anachronistic. Facts. So, shipyard... Much as I want to build an anchorage, it's not going to be good economic. Stuff it, anchorage. We need that. We definitely need that. And a resource silo. Why not? But yeah, it wasn't mass immigration. Mass immigration is very much a modern thing. It's bad. Well, there's ancient instances of mass immigration, and it always followed bloodshed because the people wanted to find a new place to settle. It was immigration by trickling, by families and individuals and all that. Which is not really the case with Stellaris, because as soon as you open the borders, as soon as you open up immigration, so I think we got immigration policy. We got refugee policy. No, citizen species only. Okay, that's what I was going to say. Refugees welcome. Refugees are not welcome unless they're citizens. Unless they are good space Israelites. Unless they are space relites. Population controls are... I don't think the Torah permitted that. So, yep. But if it's on, but we got to, if we're going to be exterminating another empire, that would involve population controls as well. So, well, while we're doing that, once we've exterminated all our neighbor empires, then we're going to get rid of, then we're going to go back to displacement only, and population controls will be removed because the Torah doesn't give that power to the state. Robotic workers outlawed. Yep, wealth creation, militarized economy. It should be mixed. Yeah, it should be. It should be mixed. Mixed economy. Israel wasn't particularly militarist with their initial border status open. Yep. Cautious. First contact protocol. Cautious. Yep. Land appropriation. Should have some of the land appropriation from non-citizen species. Yep. Oh, yeah. 100%. Yeah. Resettlement prohibited. Forceful resettlement prohibited. I'm thinking I'm going to keep like that for now. Because in the end, the tribes of Israel were given their territories. It's not like they can just be taken away. Unrestricted wars expansions. Yep. Cool. We're going to have this for now, but as soon as we're done taking over our neighbors, we're going to change that because expansionist, you know, that's probably it. The expansionist diplomatic stance is what's giving us the bad rep with our neighbors from the outset. So, you know, let's look at the benefits of this. Should we, so outpost build cost, -10% colony development scene, but it gives 100% border friction, isolationist, monthly unity, diplomatic weight down, belligerent. Oh, let's go for... Oh, yeah, no, let's go for this, 100%. Yeah, we don't need expansionists. The benefits are very meager. And the disadvantages are pretty bad. Look, he kind of went up already from the tense relations to neutral relations, even though they're hostile still. So they are less likely to go to war with us, which may stave off their wrath a bit. But the belligerent stance additionally gets rid of the expansionist border friction penalty, and it boosts up us militarily, which is great. It's fantastic. Chopo, the other Paul in the chamber of perpetual racism. I'm not racism. I'm not racist. Racism's a crime, and crime is for Canaanites. Jokes, lol. Chopo, we did a mass immigration to Illyria, and as far as I get it, we just assimilated most of them over time. Louis says, I assimilated some chicken earlier. Bro, you know what? Thanks for telling me. I'm probably going to do that later today. I might go to my KFC or something. Eric Bishop quoting me, I am not racism. Yes, I am not the abstract concept of racism. Please believe me. Hashtag believe. So this is going to be good. So I can build up this defensive fleet here a fair bit, as well as this starbase down here. And so long as these guys just don't attack me straight away, we should be all sweet. Let's look at neighbor opinion. So these guys both hate me. These guys are cool with me, so that's good. And these guys all do not like each other, which is good. This means they're not going to ally with each other and attack me all at once as allies. Louis, the CEO of racism. I did start a Stellaris save once, like a meme save. I only went on it for like a few hours, not even. A meme save where I started as a mega corporation, because you can play Stellaris as a mega corporation, and the corporation's just called racism, and then the leader of that corporation is the CEO of racism. Oh man. Chopo, Paul, the platonic form of racism. No, I'm not racist. I just really want to exterminate these other alien species because they're in our promised stars. I don't see how that's so difficult to understand. Eric Bishop, are these other nations NPCs or actual players? They're NPCs. If I was to do other players, it'd be way too complicated, too much effort. The NPCs do provide a good challenge, but I don't want the unpredictability of other players. So yeah. And of course, there's like getting other players to play with you. Like, it's not like you can just jump into a public server or something. Are there that? No, I don't think so, because you have to start a new game with people. That's the thing. What can you pump into? I don't know. It's just too complicated. Too much difficulty for the fun I want to have. I want to have fun with this. I don't want to be in constant stress over another player. We have an unemployed specialist. Research labs will get that soon, so it should be all G. Excavating archaeological site. You're surveying. Oh, dear. No, we actually do have another... I initially thought this was just going to be a dead end, so this would be the only choke point. This is still a choke point, but now we have another entryway down here. Good news means that we can investigate more stars, so that's nice, that's awesome. You need to keep surveying down here. And you know what, we need to get another science ship happening. So that we can survey even more, quicker. and resource silo, yep. And expand. Just keep on expanding. Ah, crap, I don't have enough alloys. Louis says, speciesism. Yeah, close enough. Chopper says, you can have mandatory racism / religious supremacy / burkas in RimWorld ideology. I'm going to get RimWorld. Okay, yeah, you've convinced me. I'm probably going to get RimWorld now. Eric Bishop, be careful. The alien children might throw space rocks at you. Well, not to worry. We'll reply with nuclear missiles. Chopper, why does your empire look like a deformed foot?
Just the shape, bruh. That's so mean, bruh. That's just the shape of all the territories we picked. Like, there's all this free space up here. Like, you can already see here, this guy's like a independent trading hub or whatever, and there's no one with borders next to them. Oh, but okay, we haven't discovered them, so we don't know that. But there's so much open space here, and there's a little bit down here. We have so much space to expand. Eric says, literally the shape of Turkey. Okay, don't give me that. That's too far, bro. I don't appreciate that insult. My empire's the shape of Turkey. I really don't appreciate that, bro. Come on. Come on now. We're all friends here. Okay, what deficits do we have here? Two specialists going down. What's up? What's wrong? That's actually good. They're going to fill up extra jobs at the bottom. Because we don't have more specialist jobs, which is, that's actually good. It forces them to take up more of the lower class jobs. And there's a lot of vacancies there. Just like the real economy. Okay, how are we doing our starbase? So I'm thinking I'm going to start... Okay, for our first conquest, I believe I'm going to aim for this guy first. I'm going to take these two worlds and the stars over here. And maybe one or two of these other stars if I feel like it. But yes, we need to lay some claims now. We're going to start doing that. And that's just going to put us on the warpath. And the thing with this game is that you don't want to take over too many systems at once, because that can absolutely cripple your economy. So starting with these two systems will be good enough. And I also want to get more intel so I can actually lay claim. I can actually discover these other stars and lay claim to them. Gather information. Launch that operation. Good. How about these guys? How's our espionage going here? Not too shabby. Let's gather more information so we can expand further. Andrew says, wait, you have KFC down in Aussie Town? Oh, bro, we do. In fact, KFC is even better here. I went to the States and I had KFC and your chicken sucked. This is in New York, so maybe it's not representative, but it sucked. It was like if someone got like a cornflake cereal, you know, those orange flake cereal, whatever your equivalent in the States is. It's like someone got chicken and just covered it in that, which is actually a popular way of making crumbed chicken, like with a cornflake cereal, but it doesn't taste anywhere near it. It doesn't taste nice. It can taste nice depending on the person, but it doesn't taste like KFC. It's too sweet of a flavor. And that's basically what I got in New York. But Australian KFC is the best. We have the best crumbed fried chicken of the major chains. So, yeah, we do have KFC in Aussie Town, and it's actually a staple down here. So, there you go. Eric Bishop, only if you're quadrivax. Gib kebab. I love it. Chopo, seriously though, message me when you finish the stream. If I'm still awake, I'd like to help this project of yours. Which project is your... Because I have a bunch of projects happening, but which project are you talking about, Chopo, that you'd like to help me with? I appreciate it either way. I don't know what project you're talking about, though. Oh, hello! They declare war on us. And they want to take those two systems. Okay, worst case scenario, if they win... That's actually not a bad loss. Only these two systems. They have some resources, but that's not going to be bad. They only want those two systems. Okay, this is good for us. Okay, perfect. Let's move our fleets down here. Let's get ready for war, boys and girls. Okay, reinforce this fleet. Okay, boys, we have our first war. You know what? Former agents disavowed. You know what? I should lay claim to their systems too. Okay, so they have a planet here, so I'm going to take that. I haven't discovered these systems, so I can't take those. This is good. This is very good. Do I want to take two? This is great, because this is going to be a choke point against them. I'm literally going to cleave their empire in half by controlling this choke point. That's going to be hilarious. Chopo, the gamey, of course. Oh, perfect. Heck yeah. Heck yeah. Maybe if I stream other games as well that are more conducive to multiplayer... Like Minecraft, for example, because I've actually the reason why I've stopped doing Upon This Block for now, which is my other Minecraft series I was doing earlier, is because it can get boring when you're playing on your own. But playing with friends, 100% fun. So if you've got Minecraft, I'm more than keen to get Upon This Block started up again. But yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are at war. And so far, I'm just going to take these two systems, which is going to be great. But the strategy is you always let your enemy attack first. You let them attack your starbase with your fleet next door so that once they get engaged, your fleet comes in and your combined fleet and station power will destroy them. Eric says, is this a holy war? This is indeed a holy war. Oh, yes, Logos, I remember you have Minecraft as well, so 100% you can join in as well. Unfortunately, our boy Christian Wagner is not much of a gamer, so that's cringe. He can't join us. And yes, Eric, they declared war on us, but now we've laid claims, and now this is going to be a holy war. Everyone give me an Alhamdulillah in the chat with a raised finger emoji. So, Alhamdulillah, this is for Yahweh. Give me that in the chat, boys and girls. Let's do this. This is holy war, and it is kosher. It is 100% kosher, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Yeah, there's these little event timelines as well, like with spy operatives and all, which is kind of cool. It adds to the realism in the game. Louis, I don't speak French. This isn't French, guys. Hey, just copy Eric Bishop right below you. Alhamdulillah, with the word and the up finger. That's what we're doing, boys. I need that. We need that, boys. We need to express this solidarity against the unbeliever. The unbelievers who are attacking us, daring to encroach on the people of space Israel. We will destroy them, ladies and gentlemen.
Construction complete.
I love this solidarity in the chat. Got 8 people here. How good. What a good turnaround from yesterday. Eric, alien pagans. That's right. These alien Canaanites think they can stop us. Ha! What a joke. What an absolute joke. And we got fleets coming in. That's good. But we need to definitely buff up this fleet even more. Fucking 2 more should do the trick. Get market. Sell some minerals. Sell some food. Some consumer goods. And buy a bunch of minerals. We are losing so much energy. What the heck is up with that? Okay, these guys are sapping a lot of energy. We don't even have technician jobs here, so yeah, we need to do that. And we're losing food again. Yay, fantastic. Let's build 2 generator districts. Actually, no. 1 generator district and an energy grid. Heck yeah. Ashdod, you're doing okay, but you need to get your mineral upkeep up. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this is happening, boys. Supreme Pirate King, good to see you here, mate. The Interstellar Vatican. No, we are not the Vatican. We are not the... Oh, here we go. We're not the whore of Babylon called Rome. Here we go. So this is the enemy fleet. So for comparison, okay, we've got a 962 military power rated station. It's not all just military power, by the way. That's just the summation of your power, of your armor, your weapons and all that. But the mix and matching you do with your armor on your ships and in your fleets, the mix and matching you have with your armor and your weapons, like the kinds of weapons, because different weapons can do damage, more or less damage against different types of armor, as well as your fleet composition, that all affects it. So sometimes a lower fleet power, and of course the technological advancement of your weapons and armor. So sometimes a lower fleet power fleet can crush a higher fleet power fleet if they have those advantages. But in this early stage, that doesn't matter as much because there's only corvettes so far. The enemy has... Where the hell did they get a cruiser? What? Oh, that's bull. That's absolute bull. And we only have corvettes. How did they get cruisers that early? I actually don't get that. They must have done like an event that got them a cruiser somehow, but they also have destroyers. I mean, destroyers kind of make sense. I should have destroyers by now, but I don't. Yeah. But, yeah, that really does... Okay, so this is going to be a bit of a challenge, but it shouldn't be too much of a worry because we've got defensive platforms. I'm going to build 1 more. Although their fleet's going to get there before then, so maybe. So whatever. But we have our other fleet here ready to go with 12 corvettes. That should overwhelm them. Logos says, Nasheed playing in the background. Paul, we are not the whore of Babylon Vatican. Logos Swanson has entered the chat. Oh, man. Swan, if you're watching, please get in the chat. Let's have that. You know what? We want Nasheed in the background. Ultimate Nasheed Collection, 1 hour of inspiration. I hope these. No, you know what? Quran reading. Recitation. 10 hour Quran recitation.
This revolutionary new device can remove up to 10 times more earwax than a traditional cotton swab.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, the war is starting. This is me trying to appease Shia Alex. Actually, I'm still a couple of those words. Alright, so now they're attacking my station. Okay, they've engaged, which means we jump in our other fleet. We're probably going to take some losses, but they should lose as well. Hashtag disavow. Oh, these guys are at war. Alright, meme's over. Yes. Oh, crap. They have another... That's not good. Okay. You know what? Jump back. Or should we? Stuff it. Okay, the Yosef fleet, they're going to sacrifice themselves to at least give them a dint. Yes, that was auto-tune. That was auto-tune in that Quranic recitation. How based? we're gonna get you guys in this station. I think I might let them attack this station. Go up. So I might let them take this next star and then this station. But once they attack this station, we have these fleets here. So you know what? You guys are going to be stationed right here. I'm going to buff you up. Eric Bishop says, if Allah is with us, nobody can be against us. Space Rome will perish. Alhamdulillah. That's right. Logos says, or you can have a Mikadem Psalm 150 playing in the background or Yama Ensemble Psalm 104. Hey, that's an idea. Let's do that. What's Psalm 150? Let's check that out. If it's like a war psalm. That's too short. Yeah, whatever. Psalm 150 Hebrew. Jewish music. I got the shofar. Okay, these guys are doing it over Zoom. This should be. This ain't bad. This is some victory war music going on here. What is that button? When you win, play Hava Nagila. I agree. This fleet has sacrificed itself, but it's caused massive damage in the enemy fleet. I'd wage war to this. Yeah, I agree, Louis. Okay. They've taken the station. They're going to recharge it. This slaps. I 100% agree. This is peak representation of the suffering of the Jewish peoples. I agree. See, the oppressor... Praise the Divine for this meeting. Okay, because these guys aren't next to us, so they're not going to be purged by us. But yes, 100%, I agree. I would... I would wage war to this as well. Oh, crap. We don't have any defensive platforms here. Oh, that sucks. But this should be enough to wage them off now. Okay, that's enough. It's too happy now. This is meant to be a war. Come on, guys, really? Okay, that's good. Eric Bishop, if Allah is for us, who can stand against us? Let's get that nasheed happening. Benjamin, what is this music? It's called a mikadem. Eric, worship music in the prot sense and awesome does don't belong in the same sentence. Yeah, you're wrong. Let's play Hava Nagila. Why not? Let's do it. No, remix. Hava Nagila remix. That's what we're doing. Because that's what this is. This is some war.
How do you make anything taste like Australia? Well, I'll tell you.
I love the top comment, oi rave. Instead of oi vape. Oh, man. Alright, here we go. Oh, this is licensed though, so this is gonna get new. Stuff it. Stuff it. Licensed to YouTube by they could hear YouTube could hear it and it could let's go with the OG Harvey Nagula to make it safe. What do you guys think? Should I risk it? Risk it for the biscuit? Risk a copy strike? I don't know. Okay, this one shouldn't be copyrighted. This is the OG, Harvey Nagila. Alright, boys and girls. Okay, our fleet retreated. That is okay. Oh, no. Mikodem is an Israeli messianic Jewish worship band that sings scripture passages in Hebrew. Oh, that's cool. And we have the Aron Yahweh here, our battleship. So, if they make the tactical mistake of sending one fleet or another, one fleet after the other, that'll be even better, but I don't think they're going to be doing that. What do they got? So they've got combined 1,700. Oh, crap, we barely have enough. Oh, man, I need to get every alloy I can. Engineering research. Railgun, yeah, that should help us. Yeah, whatever. These guys are just stuck here. Interesting, so they're just not moving. You know, they're not moving at all. I hope they're not waiting for someone. I hope this is just the AI cocking up. Let's establish an embassy. I can do that. Eric says, listening to this song makes me want to learn Hebrew. Sly Rooster, Lameo, the music, BDW, quack, quack, I'm feeling Yiddish run. Okay, so I think the AI is kind of stuck at the moment, because these guys are just perpetually waiting to go hyperdrive, but they're not. So that's good for us. That we may be able to indefinitely wait for a little bit until something causes them to move, which I can only imagine that being us. Oh, yes, we... Okay. This is part of the reason why archaeological sites are so great, because you can gain awesome things, like a research option, for example. I just gained a research option for destroyers. Perfect. That's the next tier up of naval ships. So we just got that now. So once this engineering... You know what? Stuff it. Let's do... Oh, 1 month... How good... The design was... So we effectively discovered the technology, not even the option. So, perfect. We're getting destroyers next month, boys. Woo! Woo! This is the grace of the Lord right here. Sly Rooster says, I miss Stellaris, but waiting for Vicky 3. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I haven't played the original Vicky much, but I've heard good things about it. Oh. What are these guys doing? Okay, these guys are taking this system now. That's nice, Gary. Well, not nice, Gary, but whatever. Okay. We should have enough once they attack our... Okay, here we go. This is the decisive battle, guys. We must win this battle, guys. We have the Lord on our side. We must win this battle. This is decisive. Whoever loses this battle, it decides the war. It's not a big war. They're only intending on taking those two systems, so it's actually not the end of the world if we lose. In fact, it's not a bad result at all. And the 10-year mandatory truce, which forces us not to go to war, will give us a lot of time to build up. And maybe even in that time, attack these guys. But either way, we're not going to lose, okay? We're not going to lose here. This is a decisive moment. Research space torpedoes next. This is a decisive war. Benjamin, it's been several months since I played a good old Paradox game. Oh, yeah, Paradox games are great. Well, ironically, it's a Paradox. They specialize in strategy games, and yet they make some key blunders that I don't think a specialist strategy developer should make. But, oh, well, that's just them. Oh, yeah, we didn't sign this guy next. Survey speed. Yep, okay, we need to survey all these systems and get building star bases. But we can't do that just yet because we need to devote all our allies to the war. Okay. Here we go. It's battle time, boys and girls. We should win this. Or not. Yeah, we're not winning this. Oh, come on. They got another... Are you flipping kidding me? Let's just freaking surrender. Yep. Yeah, okay. That actually annoys the hell out... That annoys the bloody hell out of me. And now we're no longer a valid rival because our fleets just got annihilated. Far out, that annoys me. Sly Rooster, didn't pray enough, yeah. Louis, gotta bring the Ark into battle, mate. Well, we did, that's the thing, we actually did. This battleship here is the Ark of the Lord. We were unfaithful somehow. You know what? It might have been because we set up multiple temples at one point. It might be. That might be our judgment for that. Yeah, bad move there. Oh, well. Oh, well. The good news is we get an enforced 10-year truce, so they cannot attack us at that time. How are these guys towards us? They're only suspicious. They shouldn't attack us, which will give us plenty of time to rebuild. And then... either just let these guys remain suspicious and just get retaliation on these dudes, or, you know, that's probably what we'll do. We're going to use the next 10 years of this game, 10 in-game years, to crush our enemies. Hang on, how long is this stream going for? Only an hour, that's good. That's good. Yeah, that sucks. That really, really sucks. Okay, so we haven't lost all our ships, of course. Oof, does that make you Saul? Maybe. Sly Rooster, got to sacrifice more land. Should have had priests consult the Urnim and the Thummim. Yeah, probably. Oh, well, we get an ascension perk at least, and we're going to get technological ascendancy, which means we get better research. Yeah, hegemonic imperialists, so they want to conquer everyone as well. And they're big at the moment, which is not good. Okay, so the strategy right now is simply expand, 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 get all the resource production we can. That's the key thing with this game. You don't necessarily need a good military right away. You just need to make sure you're getting a ton of resource. We're doing fantastic for minerals. We're doing really, really good. Because the key thing is that you can use the market to sell excess resources in order to buy more critical ones, like alloys, for example, which is like the resource for military, because that's how you build your fleets and stations. Yes, we definitely could have done better there. Maybe I just wasn't expanding fast enough. Ultimately, the Lord didn't have faith with us, unfortunately. But, we gotta look into the material reasons why as well. Oh, okay, so these guys are insulting us now. Well, that's great, they hate us now. Fantastic, and they're taking advantage of the fact that our fleets are virtually non-existent. I do not want to do a restart. I do not want to do a game restart. Can I improve relations with these guys somehow? Not right now, I can't. Actually, no, I can. I've got a lot of resources. I can just offer them some resources. They like energy. This will temporarily stave their wrath. Yeah, that's good. Okay, that's a good outcome. Alright. Sly Rooster. Hey, the other Paul. Care to explain the conquest of Canaan, destroying all the kids and animals and whatnot? Always struggle to get a good answer. Resources for understanding it. That's more or less this stream. Okay, this helped a slight bit. So I will explain, and that's basically what I did with the first episode of this, because that's what this all is. It's like, it's just taking that and putting it in a game. So it's like, this is kind of, if you think about it, this is kind of a way that I could help people who struggle with it cope, to just make it a game, I guess. But my answer to it is that there's so many super elaborate debates on the particulars of the passages, what they're actually saying, and 12 billion different issues, and moral philosophy and all that stuff. But I have never seen a refutation to it, and the reason is obvious, because you can't. It's properly basic. It's simply that God willed it. How can you say it's wrong? That's it. So we can take for granted the most violent interpretation, which isn't totally true, but it is largely true, that it's just mass slaughter, genocide everyone in the promised land, and move in, including the men, women, children, all that jazz, and then just say, okay, so what? Why is it wrong? And then they'll give you a thing, oh, that's bad, they're innocent people, and all stuff. And then you just got to ask, you just got to do the Socratic method. Okay, why are they innocent? What's the standard here? And it always ends up going back to just a vague, abstract, liberal enlightenment philosophy that has some abstract morality, either absent from God or based on the liberal enlightenment God, which is not the God of scripture. And to which you can simply reply, the God of the Bible, the basis of all reality of the universe, says that this must happen. There is no basis by which to say it's wrong. That's it. It's very simple. That's really all you need. Obviously, it's emotionally unsatisfying, for which there's more responses, but intellectually, that's all you need. That's it. Like, there is no response to that. There is simply none to that. Now, the emotional, there's still the emotional issue. People can say, oh, but that just seems bad and cruel. Why would God do that? Well, God gives his reasons. Yeah, that'd be a fair point if there was literally no reason for it, but God does give his reasons. It's very simple here. This is the promised land for his chosen people, Israel, who are intended to be the light to the nations. He promised this land to Israel, but there's already other people in them, peoples who are evil in their practice, very manifestly evil, including but not limited to child sacrifice. Their entire culture is fundamentally evil. And so God is killing two birds with one stone by promising a certain land to his people, a good, prosperous, fruitful land by which they can expand his glory to be a light to the nations, which is fulfilled in the church, but also punishing evil nations who deserve punishment. Simple as that. It's two birds with one stone. It's very good. It's very very efficient, if I might say so myself. So that's the reason. Ooh, that's research of debris here. Yes, we definitely need to research the debris of enemy ships, because they may have some technologies we don't. But yeah, that's basically it. God had his reasons for it there, and you can't say his reasons are not good enough, as I've seen atheists and liberal philosophers say, because what the bloody hell are you basing not good enough on? What is good enough? What's the standard? It's not God's standard. So that's just circular reasoning right there. The God of the Bible is not real because he's not the God of the Bible, who is the basis of all reality. That's freaking ridiculous. By his own said, he gave a reason. And at least in a very basic sense, you can say, okay, I understand that. You can. It's very easy to say, okay, I understand it. Even if you ultimately become a liberal and say, I don't agree with that. I don't agree the real God did that. But okay, you can understand that reasoning. He's giving a certain land to his people. And so that that's the thing. So that they don't adopt the evil practices of these other nations, it's not enough to just cohabitate. You've got to wipe them out. You've got to get rid of them. And that goes into the issue of Kherem, because Kherem doesn't necessarily mean kill or exterminate. I believe in multiple passages, it is quite clear that at least certain cities were ordered to be fully exterminated. But in other cases, it is easy also to see that they were simply driven out. So whether they're exterminated or driven out, that's what God ordered, so that Israel can be the sole occupier of the land, so that they have a base of operations by which to be the light to the nations. So that's all you need. That's really, really all you need. I hope that helps you out with it. Okay, so you say, Sly Brewster says, Baalism isn't cool. That's true. Louis, by what standard? That's it. That's every question. By what standard? Cyrus, so essentially, because the people were part of evil Baal paganism, they paid the price. Cyrus, okay, that's what I'm asking about Kherem. Yep, that's pretty much it. Not just because they were worshipping Baal. Like, the Lord tolerated other nations that were not his chosen nation worshipping other gods who are under him. But it was specifically their evil. So he didn't actually judge them for worshipping Baal. That's the key thing. Because he tolerated other nations worshipping other gods. That wasn't his problem. His problem was that they were doing manifestly evil acts. So that's why he judged them and wiped them out. Okay, great. So we got a space horde here, which are basically like the Stellaris recently added. It's pretty cool. They basically added the equivalent of Mongol steppe tribes. They're these little marauder clans that you can hire to raid other other nations. But eventually, one of them becomes consolidated under a Khan, hence the Mongol Empire, and they try to conquer everyone. It's really, really cool. And dangerous. Sly Rooster, good points. Awesome. Benjamin says, 99% of apologetics to Enlightenment people, philosophy should just be repeating that over and over again. Yeah, 100%. That should be it. And sorry, Rooster. Thanks. Going to process this more. Process it more. Not a problem, bro. I hope that was a help. I hope that was a big help to you. Okay, that's good. These guys also hate these guys. Okay, everyone hates each other. That's good. Everyone hates each other in this region, so that means no one's going to gang up on me. Only by coincidence of two people declaring war on me at once, which is not going to happen because... Yeah. Okay, I need to build more platforms. We have a 10-year truce with these guys, so I'm just going to move all my fleets up here. Let's get you repaired. Okay, they only have a superior fleet. That's good. I need to build more space, more defense platforms here. For that, I need to sell more minerals. But you know what? I also just need to expand. I haven't colonized any new stars for a while, which is not good. That's really good. 15 minerals in that system. You need to expand to... You need to prioritize expanding to systems that give you a lot of resources, particularly energy and minerals. So that's what I'm doing here. Louis, what y'all snacking on? I cracked open a jar of garlic cheese stuffed peppers. Ooh, wow, that sounds yum. I'm not snacking on anything but water at the moment. Because I'm on a diet, so I can't just snack on anything I want. What to do next? Let's do a fusion reactor because we're going to get some... Actually, I think we already do have some high tier upgrades. Or okay, not just yet. Yeah. Oh, no, I do have water upgrades on. That's good. Oh, yeah, we need to design a destroyer now. Okay, so I'm thinking... I want missiles. Apparently, I can't do that, though. Oh. That sucks. Or point defense. Because enemies do use missiles... Kind of sucks. Oh, well. Yeah, I think I'll do that. Okay, that's because the destroyers will be like my point defense guns. Lasers, good. Reactors, check. You go and pick it. Yep, that's what you need. Lovely. Point defense is against missiles. Yep. Okay, good. Problem is I'm not going to be able to afford destroyers for a while because I have to totally rebuild up my fleets from the ground. Which sucks a lot. And the priority fleet to reinforce is the main Hayat Elohim.
Construction complete.
Yeah, it's just water at the moment. Just water. Yeah, of course they lay claim to another system. Well, okay, when's the truce end? 2249. Okay, we have a little over 8 years left, so time is going. Need to get a move on. Okay, number one priority, get up alloy production and just alloy stockpile in general. That's the key. Keep energy balanced and actually up energy production as well, and resource production too. We need to maximize everything right now because the enemy could do a lot of damage. You know what? I'm going to build energy grid. That's going to increase our energy production on that planet. How's Ashdod going? Let's clear that. Yeah, they need more mineral production. Yeah, they need more of that. It's going to be a nice challenge, boys. All right, build another outpost there. You get building mining stations there. Okay, so we still have our main star station here, which will be good. going to be able to do, yeah. So this is a choke point. We need to hold this at all costs. We are not going to surrender this to them. Ooh. Ooh. Research option gain, quantum energy states, and tech progress gain, quantum energy state. Ooh, what's that? Quantum energy states. I want to find out what that is. Oh, I'm mad. Extra energy. Oh, freaking oath. You know, let's do that now. Oh, 59 months. No, yeah, focus on the fusion reactors first. Okay, let's see there. Having some good old Taco Bell right now. Nice. Benjamin, thoughts on addressing the age of Earth and creation versus evolution controversies? Yeah, I'm not really interested in them. Because you can plausibly interpret it either way, in my opinion. I believe, I lean towards Genesis being largely allegorical. So the age of the universe and whether we evolved or not is pretty immaterial to that, in my opinion. So long as we had the original couple, of course. But even then, some people make arguments that it can be plausibly interpreted as a original group rather than a couple, but yeah, whatever. Those arguments aren't... Like, the arguments against an original couple at the beginning of human life is just ridiculous. They're special pleading. Okay, cool. And where are these guys? Yeah, these guys are getting big. These guys to myself. Okay, yeah, those guys down there. Oh, man, with this game... Okay, cool, we have a full view of this empire. Okay, this is good. So let's actually claim the rest of these systems. Or at least a couple of them, because they're getting expensive. Okay, that's cool. Okay, how about these guys? How's our espionage going with them? Damn, they got better code breaking to us. I just need to get a full, because their empire's looking pretty large. But yeah, anyway, with those debates, I don't really care. I think with regards to science, though, I believe evolution is pretty bankrupt scientifically. Like, so many assumptions and so many leaps in logic with trying to demonstrate it. Age of the Earth, I'm less certain of. But again, because I don't think there's massive implications. There's some, but they're not truly massive implications for theology in that. I just don't really pay much attention to them. I just don't. They've laid claim to the Baranak system. Where's that? Okay. So thankfully, it looks like they're only going piecemeal with their wars against us, which, worst case scenario, if we lost again, that'd be bad, but it wouldn't be the worst either, assuming they don't try to expand up here. That'll be a real problem if they do lay claims there. Okay, good. Our resource production is definitely on the up and up. I'm going to expand, make another building on Ashdod. And what I'm going to do with that... Oh no, I need to do that. And what I'm going to do with that is build an alloy foundry so that we can get a ton more alloys. Oh dear, they need clerks. Why do we always suck with amenities, bro? What's up with that? And as a result, getting low stability. That's actually gay. People just don't want to become clerks. It's so stupid. Look at that. We've got a massive deficit on Yerushalayim. That's so ridiculous. I hate... So many vacant jobs that people aren't even taking up. Unbelievable. Oh, well. Such is the life in Space Israel. You know what?
Construction complete.
If I don't get attacking these guys soon, the other guys to our northeast, to our east, then I'm probably not even... going to try go for attack for them, because if the 10 years comes too soon to when I want to invade these guys, then... they could potentially invade us as we're attacking here, which will be bad. In fact, I don't think I'm even going to do that. Oh, treachery of the Aleph alien. Oh, well. Benjamin, you can use 1K food to promote growth on a planet. That's actually true. Yeah, I forgot about that. Thank you. Amenities, plus 25% and immigration pool, plus... Okay, that's... Oh, I don't want to do that, because that will take... Actually, I don't know if that is a thing. Well, that's lame. How fast is the population growing? Steadily, if slowly. Yep. That's kind of lame. I can't build any more planets here, any more stations here either, or any other districts, so this is kind of stuck as it is for a while now. Far out. Okay. So my decision, I'm either going to attack these guys. If I'm going to attack these guys, I'd have to attack now. Which honestly is very... That's going to be too long of a war. It's going to take years, that war. And we only have... Yeah, far out. We only have like... Barely a bit over 5 years until these... Or 6 years, rather. 6 years? Yeah, around 6 years until these guys... Our truce is over with these guys. So, you know what? I'm going to promote... I'm going to... Build. I'm just going to build a ton of stations over here. And I'll probably leave a fleet over here to guard. Should these guys attempt to attack. Still superior to us. And then I'm going to bring the rest of my fleets back here. As of before. Because these guys definitely want to attack me. These guys, it looks like they're okay with us for now. They're evangelizing zealots. So they do have militarist... Hang on. Do they have militarist tendencies? Not really. They're xenophobic. So they really just want to keep us out, if anything. These guys are militarists and they're a fanatic authoritarian, so they want to keep, they want to take us over. Those other guys, not so much. So that should be okay for... So these guys should not attack us just yet. Worst case scenario, I just give them the occasional gift so their relations stay a bit above board. So we should be okay. We actually should be okay with these guys in the west. I can focus all my efforts down here. These guys I'm going to be especially brutal with. Bombing the heck out of their planets. Energy credits from... What do I want first? I think I want improved deflectors. Yeah. Logos, I had to call a friend. What did I miss? I was basically strategizing what my next move is. These guys here, they don't really have the warlike tendency. And they're not hostile with us, so we should be okay. They won't attack us, which means I can focus virtually all of my military resources down here. And in preparation for once the truce with these guys is over and they attack us again. So it should be all right. Benjamin, maybe it's a tech or maybe they removed it. It might be a tech. I'm not sure. Logos, who is in Israel right now in your view? Confessional Protestantism plus right-believing evangelicals? Well... I believe after the New Testament, in the New Testament period, there was still proper ethnic Israel. Israel is still Israel. So I don't believe, per se, the church is the new Israel. So I don't believe in a strict supersessionism, but because I believe Paul's language is actually quite clear. There is a distinction between Israel and the church. Now, whether the ethnic group of Israel still exists today, I think even if the Ashkenazim, which is the majority of Jews today, are not... Are even only loosely connected to the original Israelites. I think there is evidence for that because they went up to Ukraine, intermingled, and then whatever. There's still continuity. There's still national continuity between the majority of Jews today and the Israelites. So I believe they can, in a loose sense, still be called Israel. And then, of course, you've got your ethnic Jews who are in the diaspora, like the Ethiopian Jews, for example. They're clearly of Israel. So Israel... in that ethnic sense, still exists today, albeit very different. But, and the church is not Israel. Rather, as Paul says, the church in Israel, the church is grafted into something more fundamental in Israel, and that is Abraham's promise. So Abraham's promise originally only encompassed Israel, but, as Paul himself proves, was intended to encompass many nations. So the church is not Israel, but the church includes those nations which are not Israel, into Abraham's promise, the same promise as with Israel. So there is no distinction between Israel and the other nations, but the other nations are not Israel. The church is not Israel. The church is typologically Israel, but is not identically Israel, if that makes sense. So that supersessionism, that kind of supersessionism, I believe is wrong and explicitly contradicted by Paul, because the church is grafted onto the same promise of Israel. We're not grafted into the nation of Israel, if that makes sense. Sly Rooster, I'm Sephardi. Ah, awesome. I believe Sephardi have the original ethnic roots as well, if I'm not mistaken. Sly Rooster, them Ashkenazis ain't real. Well, as far as I'm aware, there's the Sephardis, and then there's the other group, which are like actual Semite, which can trace themselves back to ethnic Israel strongly. And I actually think that's my family ancestry, because my family ancestry on my mum's side, we were actually Palestinian Jews. I believe we're, what are they called? The Miz something, starts with M. And they're like the most strongly ethnically connected with ancient Israel. And that's actually what I am on my mum's side. On my dad's side, I think I actually have Ashkenazim in my blood. So I'm Jewish on both sides, but which is interesting. Well, going back, that is. Okay. Engineering research. Nope. Need guy with an engineering bonus. Yeah, you got a long lifespan. That's good enough. Take that. Okay, we're making a lot of minerals. That's good. Let's keep expanding, boys. Oop. Okay, that's cool. These Aleph aliens. What are they doing here? Oh, crap. We need to get out. Yeah, cool. Thank you.
Receiving communications.
Oh, crap. I need to get a... okay. Let's go. Oh, no. We can't move. Oh, yeah, because we're stuck here. So we need another science ship to rescue these guys. I remember that. Yep, establish that embassy. We'll conquer you guys soon enough. Let's rescue. Wait, what do we need to... Two science ships! Let's move here. Oh, okay, so this guy's... Oh, crap, this guy's just an immediately hostile empire here. Ah, oh, crap. Okay, that's going to be fun. Mizrahim, that's it. Yep. Jeremiah, wait. I thought you said... Hey, good to see you, Jeremiah. Wait, I thought you said 7:30 p.m. Yeah, EST. That's what I said. This was 7:30 p.m. EST when I started. Or 7 p.m. EST when I started. Jeremiah, I'm late. Well, you're here. Don't worry. I'm intending to go on for a little while longer. We're an hour and 22 in. That's good. I'm going to go for a good while longer. But I have the Christendom Weekly in half. I'm gonna push back the Christendom Weekly another half an hour. So we have another hour to go. I wonder how the 12 tribes of Israel will be untangled for the 144K. Good question. I too have some Jewish ancestry, but it's Ashkenazi. That's cool. I thought you meant 7:30 in Australia. No way, not in Australia. I said I hope I was explicit that I meant 7:30 EST. Y'all need to calibrate your sundials. 7:30 PM the message version. Now that's just silly, my man. Oh man. Ooh. Who's declared war? Okay, those two guys declared war. Yeah, that's not helpful. Well, it's not bad for us, but it's not. I'm hoping these guys declare war on someone. That these guys declare war on someone, or someone else declares war on them. Because that'll be that while their fleets are away, I'll just come in and snatch up everything. That'll be great. That'll be absolutely fantastic. Actually, yes, let's upgrade those ships. Hang on, what do we research now? No, nothing new yet. Definitely could use something new. Oh yeah, we need a name for our destroyer class. What should we call it? Kiryat Shimon. I'll just keep it as that for now. I'm lazy. So let's get a couple of those ready. Crap. I need a lot of alloys. Let's do that. Let's buy a ton of alloys. Darn, not enough energy for that. Oh, got a bunch more of these. Oh, well. Okay, where's my message onlyest bros at? Oh, yeah, that is me. Actually, I think I'll call it a shield class. What's the Hebrew word for shield? Let's get that. Strong's Hebrew shield. Margain. Okay, let's call it a Margain class. Save. Get rid of that. Bang. Calibrate. switch you guys for my game class. Cool. Alright, these ships are upgrading for whatever reason. Yehuda, okay, you guys need to be upgraded and reinforced. So let's do that. Okay, this sucks because these guys clearly have... Okay, these guys are superior fleet power to us, but these guys are not. So that should be good for us for now. As long as we can just consistently keep expanding, we should be sweet, I think. Yes. Okay. Logos, the KJV is artful, archaic, the KJV is a masterpiece, the match is artful and awful, the match is a mess. That's true. I mean, to be fair, the Eugene Peterson, so he knew the languages, he was smart, but the point of the message was to make it in common language, which I think is fair enough, but it involves a lot more interpretation, which I don't think we should do that with Bibles. But yeah, the KJV, I 100% agree. It's and so that's, I guess that answers your question, Andrew. Like, I understand what the message is trying to do, but I don't like paraphrases. I just genuinely do not like paraphrases. So that's kind of my take on it. I haven't looked at its specific interpretive things, particularly on problem passages like 1 Timothy 2:12. Actually, I think I have, but I just forget what it is. But yeah, I don't like them. Yeah, real talk. NASB for life. NASB is great. ESV. NET somewhat as well, yeah. It's not like message tier, but it is a bit more dynamic equivalence. But yes, the KJV is a masterpiece. It really is a masterpiece. Yeah, whatever. Where are those guys at? Is it these guys? Yep, cool. Let's close our borders to you dogs. Right, these guys are cool with me. For now. Hang on, how are these guys? Okay, cool. Our relations are improving. That's good. That's good, because the insult is wearing off. So we should be okay in our on our eastern front. Okay, once these guys merge. Okay, let's get the Yehuda fleet down here. Let's get you guys waiting. You guys upgraded. Let's buy... Oh boy, we're losing energy. Some more of that. Why are we losing energy all of a sudden? We have a ton. And perfect, let's build a couple destroyers. Bring you guys back up here. An ASB is like the KJV, but without the artfulness. Yeah, that's true. That's true. I'm hearing great things. I've actually read the Legacy Standard Bible. I actually really want to get it because they want to make a Bible translation that just stands for time. So it's not like the beauty of early modern English, like the KJV, but it tries to be good. It tries to do what the NASB and that do. Like, they want to keep more word for word, which is good. Much prefer that. But they also want to make it a good read. They want to make it like a good literary appeal, like the KJV. So it actually reads nice. It actually feels good when it reads really, really well. The LSB, Legacy Standard Bible. So I want to get that. It may be my normal devotional translation at some point, because it's basically a slightly updated NASB, which is really, really cool. Boy, we have a lot of research options here. What to get first? Let's upgrade our... Yeah, I definitely want better armor. Okay. It's good. Once these guys are in orbit, we should be able to get these dudes out. Perfect. All right. Hopefully the hostiles don't come back. Let's build some energy stations if we have any more in our systems. No, we do not. Not yet, at least. Okay. Oh, crap. I still don't have defense platforms here. Yep, so it's all hands on deck for... Oh, crap, only 3 years left until the truce is over. Hey, Christian, good to see you. One day the other Paul will become Lutheran, I'll keep waiting. Doubtful, but not impossible. It depends on my outcomes with... Okay, well, the sacramentology, I'm pretty solidly not for. The closest things I do have... Oh, hang on. Field manipulation. Ooh, that's cool. Okay. Perfect. Let's research this system. Can I please do that? Survey system. And you know what? You go ahead and take on these ones because I want to grab this system down here in particular. Okay. That's pretty much the closest thing I have with Lutheranism is with questioning like limited atonement, for example. But otherwise, the sacramentology of Lutheranism, not really my thing. I'm not theologically convinced of it. But yes, for those who don't know, in an hour, actually, it reminds me, I'm going to change the scheduling now on StreamYard. In an hour from now is the kickstarting again of the Christendom Weekly, which I intend to make, weekly. Initially, they were just pre-made, pre-recorded videos, but that's a bit more effort when it's much easier just to do a live stream, do it live. And any of the other boys from the other streams I'm normally on, like Christian Wagner, for example, if they want to come in, join the news commentary, they can. I've extended the invite. So I need to delay it half an hour. So if any of you is still awake, then should be sweet. And now I'm going to check my channel just to make sure it pushed back the time. And it did. Perfect. All right. We've got a few likes on it already. Perfect. Oh, I'm having a good day, people. I hope you guys are having a good day as well. Ew, hello. Okay. The Otago Associated Worlds declared rivalry with the Adiks Nation. Where's the Otago at? Okay, so they're down there. Okay, yeah, they're not going to go to war anytime soon, I don't think. Christian, so wait, you currently hold to limited atonement? Loosely, but I've heard some very good scriptural responses to it. I'm still kind of reckoning with them. I want to see like the best stuff that the Calvinists have to offer. And if they don't satisfy, then I'm going to drop limited atonement. So, yeah. KJV somehow manages to preserve original word better order while still being poetic in English. For example, KJV renders Mark 1:24 as, I know thee who thou art, which defies the norms of English grammar. Yeah, 100%, because early modern English is just a more precise language, 100%. We can even see it in because I've got a bunch of works from like the late 20th, early 21st century, no, late 19th, early 20th century, which just have much superior English to us, like much more, because it's much more detailed, way higher vocabulary, way higher range of how to use things, particularly with infinitives, for example. Like in modern English, for example, in my modern English, you wouldn't say, I appreciated your giving to me this thing, for example. We don't use that much at all, but that kind of infinitive is very common, and it works very well in many situations. Oh, great. Fanatical purifiers. Oh, no. Don't tell me they're next to me. Where are they? Okay, that doesn't look like they're next to me. Whew, that's good, because fanatical purifiers are just empires that are just constantly at war with you. Yeah. Hey, JH, good to see you here, mate. Good to see ya. Glad you could come. Yes. So that's true. The KJV is fantastic. KJV is really, really fantastic. I kind of want to see a revival of... That's a tomb world. That's not good for us. A revival of like that higher register English. Why are we losing energy? What the heck is with this? Oh my gosh. These guys are no wonder. These guys are bloody eating up the energy. No one's being a technician. Of course they're flipping not. All right. Technician is priority. That should solve our energy problems, actually. So once this month is over, let's see what happens with our energy. Technology. Yeah, not bad. There we go. We're in the net again. It's good. Let's get another energy district here, definitely. Oh, we need a governor. We haven't got one. Lead a lifespan. Yep. Let's do that. Research. Yes! Improved deflectors. That's good. Let us do this now. Yes, good. That's going to be extra energy for us. Perfect. Okay, our fleet power is definitely on the up and up. Let's upgrade these fleets now. Perfect. Okay, what do these guys get? Second layer, yet another brutal. I've got to read the archaeological finds. Whereas the first circle seemed consistent of ramshackle dwellings of the outcast and destitute, the second circle seems more in common with the space-relight notion of proper urban planning. We find several open squares our scientists assume used to be marketplaces, though anything from back then has long since decayed to the point where it is impossible to make out what they might have been. Before we start finding unusual remains in this part of the dome too, they seem to have perished in much the same way as their poorer neighbors, and we find the dead strewn all over. Nice. So it looks like we found some like abandoned world or dome or something. Yep. Right on. KJV English still has the subjunctive too. Asking a regular, blah, 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 or rather a regular, blah, blah, blah. Did you watch Dr. Cooper's justification debate with Robert Coons? Don't think I have. I've seen his response to Coons. But I didn't know they had a debate, so I might watch that, because that is interesting. I think that is definitely a good... That kind of topic, I believe we definitely have the upper hand on the Romanists. Of course, I'm a Protestant, so of course I'm going to say that. But I genuinely believe they have so many hurdles to get over, so many things to explain with the text, for example, and the theological rationale, whereas it's much simpler for us. We just need to say, look, that's what Paul says. Oh, man. What do y'all think of the NKJV? Yeah. I mean... Well, don't make people comfortable. Like, I used to be all for it for the obvious reason. Look, it's a KJV in modern English. That's cool. But, like, I don't like that idea. Now, I've gone against the idea of making people comfortable in inferior states. And in this case, I mean making people... making the KJV a more convenient modern English read. Like, don't do that. Force people to appreciate and to learn the beauty that is early modern English. It's so much better. That's how you're going to raise up civilization again, by making people not content with mediocre. Okay, I want to take this system. Yes. Cool, we have these guys in our system now. Ooh! What's that? A mutual think tank. Yes, a facility would benefit it. We can now build a curator think tank starbase. Yeah, let's do that. Sweet. Once we get the ability to upgrade to a star hold, then we can do that, which will mean more research, if I'm not mistaken. And we need to build more defensive platforms. Okay, these guys are building stations too. That's fun. Okay, let's bring this fleet back here. Okay, two more years until, Robert Coons was blatantly stumped twice. Wow, nice. Once on Sola Scriptura, once on Sola Fide. Very nice. So is this like a set formal debate between him and Jordan Cooper, or is it in Cooper's responses, video responses? JH, I saw James White recommend a limited atonement book. From heaven he came and sought her, and it's pretty much at the top of my wish list. Lots of scholars contributing. Seems like the book to get. Okay, I'm going to look that up. Thank you very much. Because if they deal with the passages I'm thinking of, that'd be very useful to look at. Subjunctive is a verb form they use in hypothetical. I've hidden your word in heart that I might not sin against you. Blah, blah. Alright, so I'm back. Good to see you again, Jeremiah. Benjamin, so I guess I have a license to read KJV in a small Bible group study with these and thous, no matter how much it makes people uncomfortable. Yeah, 100%. It makes people uncomfortable, but the more you use it, the more used to it they get, and they'll be able to understand it. Okay. This is critical now. What is the next one I go with? Should I go with subterfuge, which allows me to increase my encryption and my code breaking so that espionage becomes much better for us? Or should I go with supremacy, which will greatly increase our military might? Gee, it's actually not as effective as I thought. Huh. Oh well. Discovery is good for science. Mercantile is good for trading, which means good economy. Unyielding is great for defense. Yeah, you know what? I might actually end up going with unyielding, just because we definitely need that right now. But surrender, fortress doctrine, I upgrade cost. You know what? I think I'm gonna go ahead with. Oh, the decision is hard. What do I need? Israelites weren't great spies or unyielding. Israelites weren't great spies. Yeah, they weren't. Yeah, that's true. I guess that's part of the role-playing aspect of it. But, I mean, look, we're space Israel, so we're not one-to-one. And it's not against the Torah to be a good spy, so... it's going to be between supremacy, subterfuge, and unyielding. Unyielding will be good for us in the short term. I mean, generally it will be, but it's especially good for us in this short term with this immediate threat to our south and for our conquest and our immediate borders. So will supremacy, but less so than I was expecting. Fire rate increase, damage versus star base is plus 20%. But it does increase our naval capacity, which is good. You know what? I think I'm going to go with unyielding. Oh, but subterfuge is good as well. You know what? I think I will go with... Because the intelligence intelligence is very good in this game. Nah, stuff it. We're going on yielding. I'll go subterfuge next. That'll be my next tradition. Which reminds me, I need to increase my unity output as well. Booty, fleet. Yes, planetary hall of judgment. Let's go there next. Okay. Let's build another thing here. Fire people. Become clerks, people. God, I hate the working class. Don't quote me on that. I hate the working class. Oh, man. Logos, which is these and thous, are not a trivial thing. Yeah, that's right. It's different uses in case. Yes, yeah, different uses in case. And also the fact that there's plural. There's a difference in early modern English between plural and singular you. I mean, come on. Benjamin, you versus ye is also a singular form, but it's formal and polite form. This means when the Bible addresses God as thou and thee, it is informal / familiar. There you go. Yeah. Let's build a mining station there. Oh, that's good. We got the Sabah Yahweh. Our big army. And I do intend to take this planet in this next coming war. So I'm going to get the army ready as well. Oh, cool. We can colonize here now. Or take the system, rather. You can get... Oh, this is looking nice. This could be... If that doesn't lead to there, then this could be a chokehold. And all these systems could be up for grabs. Okay, I'm going to check that out then. Eric, I have returned! Woo! Let's go. Eric's back, boys. Frick yeah, boys. Eric is in the chat once again. Okay, we're getting a good watch for this Stellaris stream. So it does appear. Would you guys agree? So for you guys, would you say that the time that this started on this day is a good time for streams? Would you guys agree with that? Because it does seem so. It's my Sunday morning, and it would be for the other hemisphere where the majority of people are. It would be for you guys on Saturday. So that actually does seem pretty good. So do please tell me, guys, in the chat now, like for everyone watching, even if you're not interacting much, which you should, is this a good time for streaming? Yep. So it's looking positive so far. Fun fact, thou, thee disappeared from common English because it was seen as too rude. That's gay. That's so gay. Who came out with that convention? Star system charted. Guy was probably a homo who said that. actually, no, go down here. That's going to be more urgent to expand to. Come on, we need a alloy foundry. Why is there no one? Construction. Metallurgist. We've got two metallurgists and yet they're not... Oh, dear. Well, okay, this is a fallen... Okay, we found our first all fallen empire. For those who don't know, fallen empires in this game are like... meant to be these ancient thousand or million whatever years old empires that have long been stagnant. They're stupidly advanced, but they're stagnant, so they don't advance. They don't go to war until in the late game when they become an awakened empire and they want to expand again. It becomes really, really cool. Well, gang, Savior, you are approaching Synthoid Continuous Territory. These serve as refuge of Sapien, blah, 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 blah. For refugee status, please, we share the same. Okay, they're good. These guys are all right. So that's the Fallen Empire right there. Ooh, okay, so they've got this area. That's good. They form a natural roadblock for us. Yeah, that's great. Ooh, we've got an archaeological site here. So no one's going to be expanding over here. Yeah, they got that star too. No one's going to be expanding. These stars are us. Oh, yeah, these stars are ours for the taking. Perfect. Perfect. I don't even have to rush anymore. So Sylvester says, yes, perfect. Christian says, yes. Logos logistics. Saturday evening is a good time for me. Perfect. Perfect. Okay, cool. Good stuff. What I might do is push back the stream maybe an hour or so, because I'm either intending to do on this day, if I intend to do Christendom weekly streams on this day as well, because right after this stream, I'm going to be doing the Christendom weekly. So I'm thinking I'll either do it on this day or sometime in the weekdays, the Christendom weekly, maybe even on my Friday or Saturday. But yeah, we'll see about that. Andrew Bailey, have you found a church to attend yet? Yes, I have. I found a nice, kind of traditional Baptist church down in the city. So that's good. I'm going with them. Arctic World. They're a good church. I'll be going there tonight. Come on, I need a new inhabitable world, brah. Come on. Ooh, perfect. Let's build mining stations here. I don't get it. Why are the alloy foundries making more... It's probably because of our massive expansion of our fleets. Construction complete. That's lame. Not to worry, though. Let's buy more alloy. Let's buy more alloys to greatly expand the fleets. So let's expand the Yehuda fleet. Adding two destroyers. Let's keep you guys at 10 maximum. Inshallah, he will become Orthodox. Good meme, bro. Good meme. Yeah, highly doubt it. Highly, highly doubt it. I never know. You can never say something is categorically impossible, but you can say it's unlikely. Which it is. Confederate Justican Worlds. Oh, so that. Oh, maybe they came through here. Oh, there might be a link through here. Ah, darn it. Oh, well. Oh, well, I can still take these worlds. Logos, I can't. Yes, Orthodox Baptist. Logos Logistics, I can't bring myself to play video games much anymore, but watching poor roleplay of Space Israel is something I can enjoy. Much appreciated. Much appreciated, my dude. I really hope you guys enjoyed this series. If you have any suggestions, feedback, please send them through. Andrew, glad to hear. This is a good time for the stream IMO. Yes, perfect. What I meant for is that Christendom Weekly, this is the time. I'm going to stay with this time for Stellaris. The question is whether to do Christendom Weekly consistently right after this stream, because it might be a bit late for some people, but that's typically not a problem. Or if I should do it on another day, like a weekday, for example. Who knows? Orthodox Presbyterian, mayhaps? I do ideally want to go for a Presbyterian church. I actually do. But there's just not a good one near me at the moment because of all the mask mandates. Yeah. But, oh, well, okay. We got under a year until the truce expires, so these guys may want to declare war on me pretty soon. So we're going to do one last big expansion of the fleet. And God willing, that will be enough for us. I just hope they're not too far. Actually, there's a cheat way you can check how far technologically another... or maybe not. Huh. Well done, they fixed it. There was a... Oh, no, wait, research agreement? Can we... is there a way I can check that? No, apparently not. Well, that sucks. Can I do it with these guys? Huh. Apparently not. So there used to be a cheat way... Actually, no, I can still check here. There is a cheat way here you can check your technological advancement compared to other empires. Oh, dear, so I'm 224... Oh, bro, these guys are technologically inferior to me by far. That's great. It's just that other empires have a higher victory rating to me for other reasons. Yeah, that shouldn't be an issue, though. Should not be an issue. So these guys are well technologically under me, which is great. So I should have the edge. I might have the edge technologically with my fleets.
Technology secure.
There we go, that works. Yeah, we gave a few cloak positions. Perfect. We got a ton of energy now. That's good. What to research next? Oh yeah, we finished the tech research here for extra energy credits. Perfect, perfect. We're gonna do very well in this war. UV lasers, we'll do that next. What do we research for? Oh yes, we got the upgraded armor now. Even better. These are all very good options here. I'm going to go with afterburners, because those will be extremely helpful. Alright, let's really quickly upgrade our ships to get that better armor. What do we have so far? Perfect, we got better armor and shields. Cool. Okay, now we do need that. Perfect, we're doing really well. Random question. There is no such thing as a random question with this stream, particularly if it's related to Bible, theology, and history, and politics. Go for it. Jeremiah, random question. I started my discipleship program yesterday. They asked before the meeting to write my testimony to share the gospel. I wasn't too sure how. My testimony, write my testimony to share the gospel. So, like, Oh, okay. So, well, I haven't done that myself either, so I'm... But the way I can think of that happening is that you're just going to give your testimony how you came to faith and then try to relate that, try to communicate that in a way to another person as to entice them to the gospel. And that's kind of how I think of it. What is the most cringe, worst Bible translation? Worst by... Logos is correct. The Passion Translation. Mike Winger actually thinks this other translation by this other, like, South African cult leader is even worse. I forgot what it's called, but it's... In some ways, it may be. But the Passion Translation, in terms of major translations, yeah, definitely the worst by far. It's not a translation. He calls it a translation. If he called it a paraphrase, it would be a little more forgivable. But even calling it a paraphrase is too much. Because it is quite literally a targum. If for those who don't know... The ancient, what they called the Targumim, were ancient Aramaic translations of the Hebrew Bible that have the main text and then they expanded, they introduced additional parts to it that basically acted as elaborations and commentary. The Passion Translation is basically that, but sells itself as a translation, which is very dishonest. And he even says, the main guy even said that it's good for your personal study of the Bible, which is... shocking. That's just a straight up lie. It's not. That's just... I think he's deluded. I think the guy's deluded. He's not a liar. I think he's genuinely deluded. It's bad. If I had to be Protestant, I'd be High Church Lutheran or High Church Anglican. Yeah, fair enough. And so I asked them that day, what should I put in my testimony? And they said, when you had a personal encounter with Jesus. Yeah. I don't like how they frame it. Often. Okay, they just laid claim to another system, Yathamir. Okay, so they have claimed this choke point up here. So this war is... This is an existential war, guys. This is an existential war for this empire. If we can't win this, then we're going to have a lot of problems. Change this somehow. Yeah, let's do that. Let's change that. Yeah, this communications jam is going to be good. Negative 20% sublight speed and negative 20% combat disengagement chance for enemies. But what the latter one is, combat disengagement chance, is that when you're in combat, when a fleet's about to be destroyed, there's a good chance that it'll just disengage, which means it'll stop fighting, it'll fight away. But once the combat's over, it'll be able to rejoin the fleet and not be destroyed. But with this expansion for the space station, I decrease that chance for enemy ships by 20%, which means they have a 20% lesser chance of not being destroyed, which is great. That's great for me. It'll mean they have a much harder time recovering, even if they win. Curator think tank, I'm going to get that one. Starhold upgrade. If you're down with Afroduck, quack twice for the stream. Afroduck, what the heck's Afroduck? Oh, man. The Passion Translation versus the JW New World Translation. Unironically, the New World Translation is superior. It's critically worse in the sense that it actively tries to remove references to the deity of Christ. But other than that, it can be an okay translation. Pretty bland, but okay. It is on the New World Translation is unironically a better translation than the Passion Translation. That's how bad we're talking. Looks... Oh, damn, we need more alloys. We need way more alloys than this. Oh, crap. The truce. Okay, the truce is over. They've closed their borders to us. We're going to close ours to them. They could attack us at any time now, guys. We need victory here. Oh. Hurry up and upgrade.
Vessels upgraded.
Vessels, okay, you get your asses back here. Okay, these guys are fine with us. I'm just going to bring the Yosef fleet over here as well. I can't be too safe. We need everything. We need everything here.
Construction complete.
Okay. Okay. Mum texted me that she'll be home soon. That's nice. The duck with the afro here. Jeremiah, I hear heresy. Joke. How dare you, cuz. There are actually worse translations than the TPT and New World Translation, which intentionally insert, LGBT, feminist, etc. Yeah. So, I say the worst in terms of the mainstream print translations, because it is very mainstream. there are individuals who translate the Bible, and they're probably even more atrocious in some ways. But that's the thing. You can't even call the Passion a translation. So it's very hard to compare. But yes, there is like the Queen James Bible, I believe it's called, which is like gay affirming. So it's literally the gay Bible. So it's not a Bible. I like the New Living Translation. Yeah. Well, they actually changed the name to the New Living Bible, I believe, because they weren't intending on it getting popular. And they wanted to rename it because it wasn't a translation. It was a paraphrase. But I think it's less so than the Message, which is good. The NKJV, ESV, and the NIV. Yeah, okay. Yeah. There you go. People give a lot of crap to the NIV, but a lot of it's undue. A lot of it's really undue. It's a pretty standard translation. There's very little wrong with it, but people give a lot of crap to the NIV, mainly because it did with the gender neutral language, which isn't fully unwarranted, because often when the scriptures talk about men or whatever, they actually are inclusive of both sexes. But I would still keep it that way anyway, because I believe in being as word to word as possible. And it actually shows something key with the ancient mindset and preserves in the Bible of how men in the masculine sense could be inclusive of both men and women, but not vice versa. It shows how the sexual dynamics recognize the primacy of masculinity in society. And so it could be inclusive of both men and women, whereas women, plural, can't be inclusive of both men and women. I believe that's actually something very key to understanding the sexual ethics and dynamics of the scriptures, which people do not appreciate. So it's technically true to translate them as gender neutral, but it actually misses something very key in the worldview of the ancient biblical worldview. It's definitely something, since we're coming up on my theme now, this coming week, my theme, I'll have a stretch theme of egalitarianism and biblical sexual ethics. So I'm going to put some content. My first thing coming out with that is a Galatians 3:28, whether it's actually egalitarian or not. And I'm going to be demonstrating through exegesis that it is not. And I'll probably also put something out on that, on why gender neutral language in the Bible is actually not good. So yeah, I'll probably do something like that. I prefer my Dead Sea Scrolls. Based. Absolutely based. So the big problem is that they have some big fleets. If I remember correctly, they had almost 3,000 worth of fleets. Almost. But not quite. It says equivalent, but with this game, these rough estimates, which you get from espionage. Oh, crap. So they got better encryption than us. Oh, that sucks. That really sucks. It's a big breadth. So a fleet can be called equivalent, but they could still be quite more powerful than you. So you shouldn't put too much solace in it. So I'm going to keep busting up my fleets, keep making them massive. Okay, what do we got? Okay, going through the final layer. This excavation site, this archaeological site, has taken a while.
Construction complete.
Okay, what else to manage with our empire? Food is tanking far out. Yeah, these guys are far out. Okay, we need to balance farmers and clerks. Yeah, that kind of works, I guess, but now we're losing a bunch more energy. Fantastic. As long as it means we don't run out of food for the whole bloody empire. That's what I find so stupid with this game. It centralizes everything. It doesn't let planets remain independent. Oh, well. Oh, crap. These guys are expanding up here. Done. Didn't really get the opportunity. Oh, well. Ooh, we lost an admiral. Of the Yehuda fleet. Okay, let's get a new... Oh, there we go. This guy's actually named Yehuda Amar. I don't have to change it. And that's a good... Ooh, but leadership experience game. Nah, this is good. Sweet. Okay. Fuck, this admiral's old. Nice. What Bible translation do you use, the other Paul? A Dead Sea Scroll guy, eh? There's not really a Dead Sea Scrolls translation. Well, there is one Bible I know, but apparently it's been ridiculed. I've heard it's ridiculed because apparently it's actually just a stock existing translation with some notes. For study, I typically use my Net Bible here, not because of the translation itself, although I do often use that translation, but I'm starting to not use that translation anymore with my videos. But I often use it just because of the scholarly notes, which are freaking ridiculously detailed. They're really helpful for study. But otherwise, I'll typically use For devotional, I'll typically use the ESV. And then for the normal academic stuff, I might jump between ESV and ASB. And still sometimes NET, but I'm wanting to get off the NET because it's a bit more for dynamic equivalence than I like. But for devotional, I eventually want to switch to the Legacy Standard Bible when I can actually buy it. Because I'm still trying to find where I can buy a Legacy Standard Bible. It's only just come out, I think. I don't know if it's even fully complete now that I think about it, but yeah. Because it does look really good. It wants to be a Bible that stands the test of time, which is fantastic.
Vessels upgraded.
Oh, you know what I should do? Hang on. Ooh. Okay, because this system, because it's a neutron star, it nullifies all shields, which means any weapons that prioritize taking out shields would actually be a bit of a waste. But I think my weapons... Okay, we prioritize armor damage anyway. That's going to be good for us. Because my ships both prioritize armor and armor damage. Okay, not really. Well, these aren't meant for armor damage anyway, but... Okay, this is actually going to be good for us. This will actually favor us in the end. Okay, good, good, good. Now we're just waiting for these guys to declare war. That's pretty much all I'm... Oh. Big on my heart. Maybe, yep, P-twist. I worry, salute you. Yeah, cool. Well, now that I think about it, these guys are about to become adjacent to us, so they might... Yeah, they might be included in the extermination conquests for the promised stars. 316 Publishing sells the Legacy Standard. Perfect. If they ship to Australia, I'm going to get them. Is it actually a study Bible? Wait, study Bible. The Orthodox study Bible or a bona fide new translation? Or the Old Testament of the OSB is a new translation. Yeah, because I believe the OSB's Old Testament is based on the Septuagint. But for the New Testament, it uses the NKJV. Yeah, Logos says use the NKJV. I invite you to evaluate the heresy / orthodoxy of the OSB by reading its Old Testament. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see the differences because it does rely on the Septuagint.
Construction complete.
Survey these stars. Why do you have no orders? All right. Oh, do these systems connect, or is this guy kind of holding it all off? Oh, wait, Benjamin says it's heretical? Of a very best questionable orthodoxy. I say bona fide as the heresies again. I would not. Oh, the judge, our Shofat Gibor, our great judge, has died. So now there is a election, not a popular election, but an oligarchic election by the heads of the tribes of Israel, of Space Israel, for a new guy. Base influence cost, trade value plus 10%. Who's the best? Because I want to prefer the one who gives the best benefits for us right now. The unity plus 10%. I'm thinking either Yonatan Golan or Yehuda Amar. But Yehuda Amar is busy with our fleet, so... Oh yeah, I haven't done edicts yet. What am I doing? Let's go with... Cost 2,000... Oh, stuff. Yeah, no, I'm not going to force an election. Okay. Who have we got? Yeah, that's good. That's pretty decent. Benjamin, Orthodox association with mysticism is bad. Well, no. Mysticism can mean many things, which are pretty legitimate spiritual practices. That's a very wide... It's a very wide brush to just say mysticism is bad. What kind of mysticism are you talking about is the issue. Okay, we need to upgrade that. I'm talking about so-called Eastern Orthodox. I know you are, but you can't just say mysticism full stop is bad, because that includes many very legitimate spiritual practices.
Vessels upgraded.
For some reason, our relation... Okay, our relations are slightly improving. But it's not going to be enough for them to not want to destroy us. Ion thruster.
Star system charted.
Oh, yes, we've got afterburners now. This is good. It means extra evasion, so they can't hit us as much. Sweet. Perfect. Let's upgrade our ships one more time.
Construction complete.
Mysticism and Eastern Orthodoxy, as in like Mother Mary kind of mysticism. Experiential attainment of knowledge of God apart from God's revelation. Gotta drop off, boys. Me and my woman are gonna watch Batman Base. Good on you, mate. Hope you have a good time. Thank you so much for coming. It was good. I really hope you enjoyed today. Like, subscribe, become patron, do whatever. Buy my merch. But yeah, it's not... Same, I'm out. Are you gonna... I'm outie gonna vidya, whatever you mean by that, mate. Glad to see you here as well, Sly Rooster. Hope you enjoyed today. I certainly have enjoyed today. Another 22 minutes, or maybe a little bit, maybe only like 15 or 10 so minutes left, and then we'll call it a stream, because then I'm going to be starting the Christendom Weekly in 20 minutes from now. But yeah, Benjamin, it's like, what do you mean by doing experiential attainment of knowledge of God apart from God's revelation? Like, I can understand that kind of criticism, like trying to go like that kind of like Buddha type route, but Orthodoxy don't consider it like that. It's not really like that. They're trying to contemplate on the truths of God, which are found in Scripture. So we come to a greater internal understanding of that. That's good. That's a great thing. Maybe you know things that I don't, which I could find objectionable, which I wouldn't be surprised if I find objectionable practices in Eastern mysticism. I know I do with their cult of saints, so, yeah. I'm talking about how Palamas articulated a whole theological paradigm just to defend his experience of the light of the transfiguration. Ooh, birth of the galactic community. Fantastic. We got the space UN happening now. What's our power? Diplomatic power? Not great. Great, here we go. We've discovered almost every other power in the universe. So soon, we're going to be able to figure out who's space Babylon, who's space Assyria. Not going to be totally certain, though, until some big powers start gobbling up small powers. So this is interesting, and this may be an interesting note by which to end the stream in a sec. I'm still waiting for these guys to declare war on us, though. I want these guys to declare war. In fact, I might even declare war on them myself soon in order to push them to do it.
Receiving communications. Vessels upgraded. Receiving communications.
Let's get some embassies. It's good to have peace with the neighbors while we are planning. Don't want to go to war with everyone. Oh, my phone's almost dead, so I'm not going to be able to view... I won't be able to view comments from my phone, so I'll just have to minimize the game every now and then. Communications.
Receiving communications. Receiving communications.
Fire, all these embassy requests, brah. Chill out. Alright, we're just getting embassies for temporary peace until we... eventually conquer the galaxy.
Star system charted.
Perfect. Sweet. Okay, this is good. We're getting a lot of alloys here. Boop-de-doo. Close my borders to you. Now I think I'll be able to... almost be able to reinforce my whole fleet and make it nice and big. So that... Oh! Hold up. Their fleet's inferior to us now. Huh! This is great. This is actually great. Oh, perfect. That's really good. That means we can... I can declare war on them now, and I'll let them attack first, wipe out their fleet, take over all my systems again. Perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, this will be... I will not end the stream just yet. I will end the stream with war. Someone said, "We went into apostles, spirit problems, be God in all truth." John 16:3. Jeremiah says, "Attack, Supreme Pirate King." You and Jeff helped strengthen my Protestantism, if that's a word. Why? Thank you very much. I'm really happy we did, Glad, because I believe the Protestant paradigm, broadly speaking, in terms of sola scriptura, although there's more fundamental issues to be sorted out there. Sola scriptura, sola fide. I believe that paradigm is the way to go about. I believe Protestantism is the faith in its historic sense, in that it takes seriously the reality and the testimony of history, whereas I believe Orthodoxy and Catholicism, they have to kind of bend history to their will in order to get what they want. Whereas Protestantism, we can be honest about history. So I believe that paradigm is really the way to go. So we're gonna start the war, and the stream will end on a cliffhanger. We will begin with a great war. So all of our fleets are being reinforced at the moment. I'll let reinforcement finish first, and then we shall declare war. Actually, no, it should be sweet. I think I'll. Okay, so I'll give it a couple months, in-game months. A few more minutes, in other words. Oh, bro, we can upgrade our fleets again. Oh, this is great. Oh, hang on, what have we got? Oh, no. The Elder One. Come on, come in. Creatures. Rip apart that machine. Yeah, because we already got that before down here. That's so ridiculous. The final layer. Site has been excavated. Great. That was for nothing, I guess. So I've got some little nice bonuses on the way. Once my fleets are reinforced, we're going to declare war. Let me claim any other systems. Any other? Yep. Claim that back. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen. War is on... The warpath we are on. Oh, can I wait? Love this debate in the chats. I love having debates in my live chats. How good. That's what I'm all about. Into the intellectual strengthening of the Christian faith. And we just researched, by the way, level 3 lasers, which is going to make our damage output even nuts, even more nuts in this system particularly, because it's higher damage to armor. And this system, you only have armor and hull. So we're going to crush their fleets. We're going to absolutely annihilate them. Oh, yeah. See the fleet military points go up as they upgrade. Well, once the... Oh, yep, they're upgrading now. Ooh, look at that. Went from 730 to 836, I believe, or 7-something. See where we're at. New tech. Planetary Hall of Judgment. Love that. Crimes lowered and higher amenities. I definitely want that. Ooh, okay. Have the health points and damage increased by 33%. Oh yeah, we're going for that. Upgrade my Empire Capital. Heck yeah. Oh my gosh. Low stability because there's no bloody clerks. Okay, we've got 2 out of 4 clerks. That's good, but not great. It's actually, this game frustrates me sometimes. Like, amenities is one of the most BS mechanics in this game. Actually, no, we can... Freak, heck yeah, we can get commercial zones. Yeah, done, commercial zones. That'll increase amenities and energy, I believe. Oh, look at our fleet power go up. Let's see what the comments are saying. Communications. What if you're wrong? There's no such thing as 100% epistemic certainty. Oh, no. Where Well, yeah, Logos is right. No such thing as 100% epistemic certainty. As long as you don't go the lay Catholic apologist and Jay Dyer route of,
well, you don't have absolute 100% certainty of your biblical canon, so that makes an incoherent system because a fallible knowledge of an infallible canon is a totally incoherent, ridiculous statement. Because reasons.
Please don't go that. As long as you're not going down that route, my man, I'm all G. We are way over naval capacity. We need more star stations with anchorages. Question is, where should I build? Huh, how cool. Hey, Logos, look at this. This star system here, this border system is called Brachium. What? Quid est Brachium, or Loge? Oh, we need more fire. We need a lot more alloys. And we need these alloys for the war effort, so I can't expand just yet. Fire, only partway through upgrading, and they're already... These fleets are already getting buff as. That's great. Oh, they're equivalent. Okay, they're building up their fleets too. Shouldn't be the biggest worry though, because we'll definitely be more advanced than them. Let's check our tech. Why are we so low on the victory score? That's a load of crap. Where are they at? Yeah, they're economically more powerful than me. That's why. Yeah. Oh, well. Okay, I want to start off the stream with the war. Once these ships are fully upgraded, which has taken a while for some reason. Yeah, why is it taking so long? Why the heck are they not? Why are you guys not upgrading? What's up with... No, let's go one fleet at a time. Alright, you guys... Yehuda, you upgrade first. The heck is... What? What's up with these guys? Oh, because of the flipping alloy shortage. Yes, yes, okay, I need a ton more alloys. Okay. Technology secured. There we go, that should... Yeah, that should get it all happening. Ooh, a lot of good options here. Let's increase our mineral output. Brachius the arm. You are correct, my man. Alright. Alright, only a few more minutes.
Vessels upgraded.
Because I need a few minutes before the end of this and... Oh, far out. Deficits. I need a few minutes before this and the Christendom Weekly so I can get my tea. Take your sweet time.
Vessels upgraded. Vessels upgraded.
Okay, should be sweet. Oop. Oh, that was quick. We lost our grand leader again. Oh, well. Okay. We need amenities. Or do we? No, we'll be sweet. We just need more clerks. Actually, I think we will do that. All resource silos or stronghold or... Let's build commercial zones. Man, this game can be annoying with the job prioritization. Come clerks, you dumb people. Far out. Okay, perfect. their fleet power. Oh, they're at war. Oh, perfect. They're already at war. That's why they're losing fleet power. They're at war with hang on, who are they at war with? So there are these guys. Oh, perfect. This is the time to attack. We attack now. Let's do it. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, this is how you end a stream right here. We are going to war. Favorite tea, says Andrew Bailey. I'm partial to Earl Grey. Me too. I'm quite partial to Earl Grey. I just like tea with milk. Yep, 100%. I like my tea with milk too. But yes, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to go to war. Ava Nagila remix. I don't think I should get nuked for it because the other guy, that other big history channel used it. So, ladies and gentlemen. Skin. Down there requires a special kind of care. That's just a flipping ad. These ads take so bloody long now. Has anyone else noticed that YouTube increased the frequency and length of ads? Pathetic. Alright, ladies and gentlemen. The war music begins. I have tried lemon iced tea, it's pretty nice. Ladies and gentlemen, a war of conquest is declared. Alright. Fleets. We are all heading to the Ventademian system in order to take him over. Let's get that war happening. Everyone, as I said in the beginning, Alhamdulillah, with the finger up in the chat. Let's get that happening. Look at that. This station just got annihilated. Absolutely crunched. Okay, we need someone for the Yosef fleet. Alhamdulillah, with a finger up in the chat, boys and girls. Let's do it. We're at war. Dabbing on their main, on their next station. Right, watch this. Watch as we jump in. Yeah, shut up. No one cares. That was quick. That was a quick remix. I thought it was longer than that. Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, Jeremiah says, I can't say Alhamdulillah. It's too common for me in my country. It's like if I say I'm saying something Muslim. Not to worry, brother. You're in this chat. Everyone knows what you mean. You're not a Mohammedan. You're not a heretic. You can say it here in all peace. Actually, no. Okay, so what we're going to do, fleet's going to repair here. Look at that. Only one of our fleets got damaged. We haven't made any casualties. That's just how much more powerful we are than these losers who dared attack us first. Okay, now we're going to move to the adjacent system. We're going to let them try and take over the this station again, but we're going to absolutely crush their fleet as they attempt it. question is, where are they? Well, that's the only way they can come through. That's why I got this choke point here, because it's the only way, it's the only way they can get to our system. Okay, you know what, ladies and gentlemen? I am going to leave us on a cliffhanger. That's right. How does this war end? We do not know yet. Will this be the advancement of space Israel into the Canaanite promised stars? Will we finally get them and begin to drive out to Cherem the inhabitants, the sinful inhabitants who dare occupy our chosen stars? Ladies and gentlemen, we will see. Thank you all so very much for watching this stream. Thank you all. This really, really made up my day since yesterday's not so popular stream. I shall exit this game. This was fantastic. This was very fun. I hope you guys all had fun as well. Yes, this is awesome. Thank you all so much for watching. If you haven't already, like, subscribe, follow my alternatives, join the Discord, become a patron if you want some nice bonuses and you really want to support me and my mission in helping Christians think with a proper worldview, no logic, historical method, be able to think for themselves. If you want to support me in this mission, become a patron or buy my merch or donate directly on my PayPal. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all so much. I will see you in a few minutes on the Christendom Weekly. God bless.